Welcome to the one more session of Embedded System and Microcontroller. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. In the last session, we studied the various types of input device and output device that can be connected to the embedded system. That is, different types of sensors and actuators. Now, in this session, you will see the keyboard. A keyboard is an input device. It is nothing but a I-pulse generator for the user interfacing. Now, in the previous session, we have studied the push button switch. Push button switch acts like a pulse generator. But the use of push button switches sometimes are limited because when we consider the example of I want to connect 16 push button switches, 16 push button switches in my application. For that you need 16 lines, like you need 16 lines or you need 16 port pin of microcontroller in order to connect 16 push button switches. So this is not possible because like the number of pins, output pins or input pins available on the microcontroller will be sometimes it is limited depending on the different types of application. So in such a situation, like if the situation demands a larger number of keys, then we are going for something called as a keypad. Because in such situation it may not be possible to interface each keys to the port pin due to the limitation of number of general purpose port pins are available in the processor, as I said. So here we are using something called as a matrix keyboard. It is an optimum solution, matrix keyboard, to handle the large requirements of push button switches. So we'll see the matrix keyboard. For example, this is the diagram shows the matrix keyboard. Here 16 keys, like 16 push button switches or keys, are arranged in a matrix like 4 into 4 rows and 4 columns. It is arranged like 4 rows and 4 columns, you can see here. So this will reduce the number of pins required in the microcontroller. For example, if you use this type of keypad, then you need 4 lines for the 4 rows and 4 lines for the 4 columns. Totally you need 8 port pins are needed to connect this one. Instead of that, if you go for 16 push button switches, you need 16 port pin. So in that way, this is the optimum solution for the majority of the applications. Now you will see how this works, how this keypad or matrix keyboard works. Here you can see in the matrix keyboard 4 columns are named as column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3 are connected to VCC through the resistor, and we have 4 rows, row 1, row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3. So this also goes to the microprocessor port and microcontroller port. This also goes to the microcontroller port, but here you can see we have push button switches, but there is no intersection unless and until there is no intersection between rows and columns unless and until you press this push button switch. When you press the push button switch, corresponding row and corresponding column, at the corresponding row and corresponding column, that is at this point it will make the intersection. Otherwise there won't be any intersection. So now we will see. So normally available keypads are in this fashion, like you can see here it is a 4 into 4 matrix keypad. 16 keys are arranged in 4 columns like this and 4 rows, and these are the 8 lines which goes to the microcontroller. These are the 8 lines related to the rows and columns, and here you can see the schematic of the keypad. Internally you can see these columns are represented by red line, and rows are represented by black line. There is no connectivity between rows and any columns here. You can see any rows and any columns you can see. Now suppose if you press the key 5, this key, if you press the key number 5 on the keypad, now you should remember there is no 5 is built in inside this push button switch. This is just a push button switch. There is no number 5 is built in into the push button switch. So when you press this key, now the question comes, you need how to make the software to interpret this as 5. That is important. How to make the software to interpret this as a 5. For example, you press this one, 8. Now the question comes, how to make the software to interpret this as 8. That is important, because this key or push button switch will not represent 8 or 5 or any number. This is just a push button switches are arranged in vertically and horizontally, that is rows and columns, 4 into 4. Suppose when I push this push button switch, then we need to identify which column this push button switch is being pushed. That is, this is in second column or column number 1, because we are starting from column number 0, and row wise it is in row number 1, because we are starting with the row number 0. So you need to identify which column and which row, then you need to make the software to interpret this as a 5. Or suppose if I press this key 9, then this key is in column number 2, because column starts from 0, 1, 2, column number 2 and row number 2. So you need to make the software to interpret this as a key number 9. So we'll see now how this exactly works. Initially, what we do is we will make all the rows with the logic 0. We will make all the rows like R1, R2, R3, R4 with logic 0, and all the columns with logic 1. We will make all the rows with logic 0 and all the columns with logic 1. All the columns with logic 1. Here you can see these are the columns C1, C2, C3, C4. These are the rows R1, R2, R3, R4. We will make R1 is 0, R2 is 0, R3 is 0, R4 is 0. Similarly, we will make C1 is 0, C2 is 0, C3 is 0, C1 is 1, C2 1, C3 1, and C4 1. Now, in the next diagram, you see, I'm going to press this key. This is the key number 5. I am going to press this key. But here, it is just like a push button, arrangement of push button switches. First, when you press this one, you should identify. We need to have a technique to identify which column the key being pressed. Then after that, in the which row the key being pressed, we need to identify these two things. So when you press the particular key, that column becomes the value of that columns. Initially what we did is we made all the columns logical 1 and all the rows logical 0, and we press this key. That time that particular column becomes the particular column, the value big logic, this one, this logic 1 turns to logic 0. Why you see, when you press this particular key, here you can see, here this is in logical zero. This is in logical zero. When you press this particular key, this is the high resistance path. This is the low resistance path. So this zero moves like this. This zero moves like this. And here already one and one is there. And when this zero moves like this, then this one makes transition from one to zero. So this zero will bring down the 1 to 0. This 0 at rows will bring down the 1 to 0. 1 to 0. So, in the diagram you can see, when you press the key, now this particular column C2 becomes 0. That means any one of the keys in this column is pressed, any one of the keys in the column is pressed. Now we need to find out in which row the particular key is pressed. For that we use one more logic, that is we sequentially change the value of rows. Like initially we will make row 1 as logical 1 and we'll check the variation in the column value. So when you make row 1 is equal to 1 and row 2 is equal to 0, row 3 is equal to 0, row 4 is 0, because we have not pressed any key in that row, there is no changes in the output value of the column. Like there is no changes in the column value. So it remains 1, 0, 1, 1. But when you make, in the second case you see, when you make R2 is equal to 1, R1 is equal to 0, R3 is 0, R4 is 0, you can see this 1 moves up this value 0 to 1. This 1, because this is connected to this switch and we have pressed this switch, so the value of C will move, like value of column 2 will move from 0 to 1. 0 to 1, the value of column will move from 0 to 1. With this, we will understand which row and which column the particular key is pressed. So the key number 5 is pressed, and we will write a program for the software to interpret this as a key 5. So you can see in the next diagram here a program is written in the while loop. What we are doing here is like first. I will check whether C1 is equal to low. If the C1 is equal to low, then it will be in the continuous while loop. Then I will check whether R1 is equal to, if R1, I will make R1 is equal to I, and I will check if C1 is equal to I. If that is equal, then I will display 1. Else I will make R2 is equal to I. And I'll check if C1 is equal to high. That time I will display 4. Else I will make R3 is equal to high, and I'll check whether C1 is equal to high. Then I will display 7. Else I will display the other value, that is star. So this if statement is for C1 is equal to low. Similarly, we will repeat this section of code for C2 is equal to low, and C3 is equal to low, C4 is equal to low, and we'll make the software to interpret the particular whichever key is pressed. So in this way, this works. So 4 into 4 keypad works in this way. So this process is repeated until scanning of all rows are completed, and in this way the keypad works. So let me repeat here. We are using here 4 into 4 matrix keypad, where 16 keys are connected in the form of matrix. We have 16 keys connected in the form of matrix. So you can see here 4 columns are there and 4 rows are there. 4 rows are connected to the 4 rows are connected to the microcontroller pin, and 4 columns are connected to the microcontroller pin. When you press any key, the first thing is normally the keypad looks like this. The first thing is Like when you press any key, first initially you need to make all the rows is equal to 0 and all the columns is equal to 0. And when you press any key, the particular column becomes, the particular column value turns out to 0. When you press any key, the particular column value turns out to 0. Here you can see. So that means you will come to know which column, in the which column the key is pressed. It can be either any one of the four keys. In order to find the particular key, what you need to do is you synchronously vary the value of R1, R2, R3, R4, or you need to sequentially vary the value of R1, R2, R3, R4. Initially, I will make R1 is equal to, and I will check whether the value of C2 has changed or not, or R2, R3, R4. So if you do this, if you repeat this all for all rows and all columns, you will get to know which key is being pressed. So in this way, the 4x4 key pad matrix works. Thank you for your cooperation.